Hello friends, today we are going to see how to write the phasing and tapetanic program on CNC lathe. Prepare the NC part program to machine the workpiece as shown in the figure on the CNC lathe. So this is the required component, and for that we are given the raw material. So raw material size given is the length is 55 mm and the diameter 20 mm. The various operations which has to be get performed here will be the facing operation, plane turning, taper turning, and again the plane turning. Before writing the programs, it's very important to write the or to understand the coordinate system. So along the length of the job, you have to consider the Z axis, and along the diameter of the job, you have to consider the X axis. Then when the tool is moved away from the face of this workpiece or towards your right side, then the coordinates will be positive along the Z axis. And at the same time, when the tool is moved towards your left side or towards the spindle, at that time, your coordinate will be in a minus along the Z axis. If you see the diametrical coordinates, means the X coordinates, if the tool is moved away from the operator or away from this origin, at that time, your coordinates will be a positive. And when the tool is moved towards the operator, at that time, your coordinates will be the negative. Also, the tool path is very important, or I can say the tool sequence. So for that, we'll show that how the tool will move from A to B, B to C, C to D, and so on. And for that, we will write the coordinates also. So first of all, A position. This is the A position where the tool will be at the home position. Then the tool will move to the B position. At that time, the coordinates along the x-axis will be the zero and the z-axis. So if you see this gap, means I have considered the plus 2 as the tool is away from the or towards the your right side, at that time will be the positive. So the as per the distance is concerned, this plus 2, you can, I have considered the plus 2, or you can consider the plus 1 also, or the 5 also, so that the just tool will come nearer to the face of the component. Then the coordinates of C. Okay, so from B to C, your coordinates at this position will be the 0, 0. Okay. Then the D coordinates, you can see that along the X axis, means diametrical size. Okay, if you see the diameter, always try to put the diametrical value. So how much is the diameter here? So at the D, the diameter will be of 15. That's why I put the 15. Why it is positive? As the tool is moved away from the operator. But when the tool moves from C to D, at that time the facing operation is already taken place. And at that time, my D coordinates will be 15 and X, Z will be 0. Next will be the E coordinates. Now see the E coordinates here. How much is the diameter? Diameter is 15. So X will be my 15 and Z, this will be your Z. How much is the length here? The length will be a 20. So you can see the minus 20. So why it is minus 20? Because tool is moved towards your left side or towards the spindle. That's why it is a minus 20. Then after that, you can see the coordinates of F. Now when the up to the E, right? Up to this E, the green part will get removed. Okay. So that the plane turning will take place. And from E to F, for that my coordinates will be, how much is the diameter? X will be my 20, you can see. And the length from here to here, how much is the length? 20 plus 5, that will be a 25. And minus 25, because again, reason is same as the tool is moved towards your left side. After that, F2, next coordinate will be my G, means this one. Again, the tool will move from F to G. At that time, again, diameter will be the same. X is 20. Okay. And how much is the Z? Z, you can see 30 plus 5 plus 20. That will be a 25. So that's why my coordinates will be a minus 55. So now you know that why I'm writing the minus here. Then after that, my coordinates h. Means after doing these operations, my tool lead move away from the components. So in that case, I consider the 25. You can consider 25, your 30 or 35. Okay, any diameter means just for a safety, the tool is moved away from the component so that I can remove the components. Okay, and then I can move the tool to its home positions. So you can see the sequence, tool sequence: A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, right? Then E to F, then F to G. Okay, after G, so this will be your G now. So then the tool will move to the H. So the coordinate systems are very important here. Otherwise, you will not get the proper profile of your job. So this, once you have decided the tool sequence, okay, then it is very easy to write the coordinates. So every programs, right, that it is always divided into three parts, I can say. Three part means it is a start of program, then second part will be the profile of the component, and third one will be the end of program. I'll tell you how it is. The first, whenever you are writing the program, just this is O, I have given the program number 1, 2, 3, 4. You can give any number there. Then the next one, these N10. Now, when I'm saying that any program is divided into three. So first part is the startup program. This will be remain common to almost all the programs. Okay. So at a glance, I'm showing here. N10 is the block number. G40 is the cutter radius compensation cancel. G80 is the can cycle cancel. Then N20, that block number 20, G28, U0, W0. This is called as end of block. So whenever you are writing the program, always put the EOB or a semicolon, which will be indicates the end of that block. Okay. Now G28 is the tool home position. Okay. In our case, I'm showing the tool home position will be A. Okay. This is the tool home position. It means that the tool automatically returned to the reference point. Then next is the block number N30 and G90, G94 and G21. G90, when I'm considering, it means that I'm writing the program in an obsolete position system. G94 will indicate the feed rate in mm per minute, means distance traveled by the tool in 1 minute over the component. That is called as a feed rate. G21 will indicate the programming in metric system. Means whatever the dimensions are there, all these dimensions are in the mm. Then the next is the N40. That M06 is nothing but the tool change. So for that, suppose I want T stands for the tool. 01 is the tool number 1, means I want the tool number 1 for the operations. And this 01 is the offset value for that tool. Then N50, M03. M03 indicates the spindle start in the clockwise direction. S1200. S is nothing but the spindle speed. The spindle will rotate at 1200 RPM. And the feed 200, it indicates that it is in a mm per minute because I consider G94. Okay. So that's why my feed rate will be in mm per minute. Then block number N60, M08 indicates the coolant on. And so this one from N10 to N60, which is called as a startup program. And after that, we need a profile of that component. So in the profile of the component, that is the second part of that. So here you can see, I'm showing the block number N70, G00, X0, Z02. It is very clear that the tool G00, first of all, is the rapid travel of the tool. As we know that there is no cutting action between the tool and the workpiece from A to B. At that time, you can move the tool at a very fast rate. Okay. And these coordinates, how I'm writing, as we know that it moves from A to B. So what is the coordinate of B? You can see x0, z plus 2. Okay. Now, after that, block number N80, G01, Z0 means tool is moving from B to A, B to C. So at that time, what is my coordinate? C00. So I can put the X0, Z0 or just Z0 because in the previous block, it is always already the X0 is there. Okay. Then after that, N90. So N90, the position where the at that time the facing operation will take place. Yahan se tool agar D pe ja raha, it means the facing operation will be done. So D coordinates in our case will be the X15 and Z0. So I'm just writing the X15 because Z0 in the previous block is already there. Okay. So no need to write a repeat again. Even if you write, it's no issue at all. Then next block is my N100. See, it moves, the tool is moving towards the E. So at that time, what is my coordinates in the E? You can see X15, Z minus 20. So Z minus 20 because X15 is already there in the previous block. So Z will be the minus 20. After that, see observe here. It means that up to this position, we have removed this green part. Okay. This green means plane turning is already done. Then I am going for the taper turning, means E to F. So what is my coordinate system in the F? You can see X20, Z minus 25. So I'm writing these coordinates. So after that, the next block will be my N120. So N20, how much is my N20 means G is the my 120 ultimately. So G coordinates will be X20 and Z minus 55. Again, I'm repeating, you can write X20, Z minus 55. Okay. Now these, after doing the taper turning operations, the tool is moving towards the G position, means again, the plane turning will take place. After that, okay, you can see I'm just moving the tool away from the component. So at that time, I'm using the G00, means rapid travel of the tool so that we can reduce the machining time, okay, or the idle time. And at that time, what is my coordinates I have taken? The X25 and Z plus 2. Okay, I have written that coordinates. So these green blocks, which I am showing there, friends, this is ultimately called as a profile of the component. Okay, so this is the first part of the program. This is the second part of the program. And the third part of the program, which is called as the end of the program actually. So in that case, I'll show you N140, G28, U0, W0. Means tool is again moving to its home position. Okay, that is the meaning of that. N150, M05 means spindle stop. As we know that we have completed the operations, here we have spindle start, this will be a spindle stop. Then M09, here the coolant on, coolant off, usko humne band kar diya. And the last block is the N160, M30. This M30 indicates the program end and tape rewind. It means that, it means the cursor will again move to the block number N10, means your machine is ready for the next job. So in this way, we can write the various programs on the CNC lathe. So thank you, friend.